I'm Lacey Lofton, a statistician and data training expert at the U.S. Census Bureau. Many of our data tools have a column or a button where you can select to view the margin of error, or MOE for short. In this data gem, we will explore the statistical concept and see how it applies to some of the data produced here at the U.S. Census Bureau.
A margin of error describes the amount of error for an estimate as a result of sampling a population instead of taking a census. If you only sample a part of the population, the sample will almost never perfectly describe the entire population, which is also known as the universe. The difference between the sampled population and the entire universe is described using the margin of error. For each data point that we publish from the American Community Survey, we also calculate a margin of error for that specific data point. The margin of error for estimates from the American Community Survey are provided at a 90% confidence level. We can use the margin of error and add it and subtract it to its associated specific data point or estimate to easily calculate what is called the 90% confidence interval. Doing this defines a range expected to contain the true value 90% of the time. In other words, we're 90% confident that the true value of our estimate falls within the confidence interval range. Let's take a look at one of our most popular tables, selected economic characteristics, to work through an example together.
The table you see here is from the American Community Survey, or the ACS for short. The 2021 ACS five-year data estimates indicate that the per capita income in the United States is $37,638, with a margin of error of $102.
By adding and subtracting the margin of error from the point estimate, we can calculate the 90% confidence interval for this estimate. Let's draw this on a normal curve and describe what we see. Based on the per capita income estimates and margin of error, we can be 90% confident that the true value of the per capita income for the entire population, or universe, is between $37,536 and $37,740. Generally speaking, the larger the sample, the smaller the margin of error will be. The more data you have, the more confident you can be in an estimate. This is the reason that our first example has a relatively small margin of error compared to the estimate. For our next example, let's look at a data point that comes from a smaller population by examining the population enrolled in kindergarten in Montana. The 2021 ACS five-year data estimates indicate that 13,620 people are enrolled in kindergarten with a margin of error of 840. By adding and subtracting the margin of error from the point estimate, we can calculate a 90% confidence interval for that estimate. Let's draw this on a normal curve and describe what we see. We take our point estimate of 13,620 kindergartners in Montana and subtract our margin of error of 840 to get the lower bound of our confidence interval. That's 12,780. Then we do the same thing, but this time we add the margin of error to the point estimate to get 14,460. This gives us the upper bound of our confidence interval. Based on this kindergarten enrollment estimate and the margin of error, we can be 90% confident that the true kindergarten enrollment in Montana is between 12,780 and 14,460.
I hope you're at least 90% confident in your understanding of margin of error, what the statistic means, and how it is used. For more videos like this, visit census.gov/academy. Be sure to subscribe while you're there. Thanks for watching.